Good morning students. Today let us start from manganese. Okay, now how does it works? It activates the number of enzymes. So manganese activates a number of enzymes which are present in our body. Okay, so manganese in the second oxidation state, okay, it will be produced in the liver and converts nitrogenous waste into the urea. So it is essential to convert nitrogenous waste into what? Urea. Then it is carried by blood to the kidney and excreted out in the form of urine. So it will be carried by the blood to kidney and excreted. Okay, gets excreted in the form of urine. Then deficiency leads to infertility in mammals. Now next element is nickel. Nickel is also essential element used for several hydrogenase enzymes and plant urease. Next slide. So arsenic. Arsenic is another ultra-trace element. So this is the essential ultra-trace element. Deficiency results in retarded growth in chicks. Highly toxic to mammals and moderately toxic to plants if present in more than ultra-trace quantity. Next is chloride ions. Essential for mammals and higher plants as sodium chloride, which is present as an electrolyte. Important role, what is important role of chloride ions? It will balance ion. Ion balance will be maintained. Ionic balance will be maintained. Okay. Deficiency in infants causes impaired growth. Next slide. Phosphorus. Now, phosphorus is also essential for life. It is the constituent of skeletal bone. Fluorapatite is formed by the partial conversion of apatite. Imparts strength to teeth. So fluorapatite is essential to give strength to teeth and also makes it less soluble in acid formed from fermentation of organic materials in the teeth and thus protects the teeth from decay. Okay, so this is fluorapatite protects the teeth from decay. Important part of energy source, that is ATP. What is ATP? It is adenosine triphosphate. Okay. Next slide. This is the reaction or mechanism shows the conversion of ATP into ADP. ADP into ATP, ATP into ADP. Okay. So, but this has not been included in the syllabus. Next slide. About iodine. Now, about 75% present in human body is lactated in thyroid gland. So iodine is present in thyroid gland. Important constituents of thyroid hormone like thyroxine. So the iodine is important constituents of thyroxine, which play vital role in metabolism and growth regulation. Deficiency of iodine causes goiter and abnormal functioning of thyroid gland. Next slide. So the picture of iodine. Okay. So the food products, the present which contain what? Iodine. Next slide. Metalloporphyrins. Now what are metalloporphyrins? So metalloporphyrins is important group of bio and inorganic compound. In these compounds, metal ion is surrounded by four nitrogen atoms of porphyrin ring. So why they are called metalloporphyrins? Metal is present, and where it is present? Inside the porphyrin rings. Okay. Porphyrin ring act as tetradendate macrocyclic ligand. So porphyrin ring is a tetradendate. Four bonds will be there, okay, for the around the central metal ion. So it is a macrocyclic ligand. Four pyrrole of porphyrin carrying substituents other than hydrogen are called porphyrin. If you have other than hydrogen in the pyrrole ring, that is called porphyrin. The complex in which a metal ion is present in the porphyrin ring system are called metalloporphyrins. If metal is present inside the porphyrin ring, that is called metalloporphyrins. Okay. Next slide. Chlorophyll. There are some examples for metalloporphyrins. One is chlorophyll. Which metal it contains? Magnesium. Mg2+. Mg2+ is metal atom. It is a green leaf pigment involved in photosynthesis. Next is hemoglobin. Fe2 is a metal atom. That is red in color and contains four heme groups. Myoglobin, Iron2 is metal atom. So myoglobin, Iron2 is metal atom. Then this is the porphyrin ring. You can see here there are pyrrole rings. So this is the pyrrole ring 1, 2, 3, third one, fourth one. Okay. So in this pyro ring, nitrogen atom, one of the edges contains what? Nitrogen atom, correct? This contains nitrogen, but in the form of NH. So nitrogen valence is 3. Okay, one is here, one is here, one with hydrogen, but is not shown here. Understood? All right. Then this is nitrogen triply bonded. Nitrogen valence is 3, correct? So it is bonded to carbon over here. It is not written. Carbon here, this carbon here. So 1, 2, 3, 3 valency. This nitrogen atom exists as NH. Okay, NH. So 3 valency. This nitrogen N. Therefore, double bond here, single bond here. Okay. Now this nitrogen atom as well as this nitrogen is called tertiary nitrogen, and NH nitrogen atom is called secondary nitrogen. Okay. NH. This one is one NH. This one is another NH. So this is called secondary nitrogen. This is called tertiary. N is called tertiary. Okay. And these rings are called, okay, porphyrin rings. Metalloporphyrin. What do you mean by metalloporphyrin? Metal is present. Can you see here? Metal. Which are the metals probably present? Either magnesium, iron, ferrous, and then nickel. Okay. So metal is present here. This nitrogen forms coordinate bond. Can you see here? Coordinate bond is formed between nitrogen and M. From where? How it is forms coordinate bond? Nitrogen has got lone pair. Okay. Nitrogen has got lone pair. Valence 3 is here. Lone pair forms coordinate bond. All right. This nitrogen on the other end forms coordinate bond, correct? 1, 2, 3 valency, 1 is lone pair. What about this? 1, 2, 3 valency. This is the valency. Okay, hydrogen atom here, from here, this is the hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom here replaced by one metal, okay, forming valency with metal or bond with metal. So this is called what? Metalloporphyrin. Alright, next slide. Now what is the structure of heme? Heme is tetrahedral complex of iron 2. So which is the metal atom present in heme? That is iron in the second oxidation state. Okay. Iron is coordinated with 4 nitrogen atoms of 4 pyrrol in porphyrin. So there are 4 pyrrol rings, you know. At the 4 corners you have got 4 pyrrol rings. Okay, that is called porphyrin, and 4 nitrogen atoms it will contain. Out of 4 nitrogen atoms, 2 are secondary. I told you already. Which are the secondary nitrogen atom? NH. If you have NH in the porphyrin ring, it is called what? Secondary nitrogen. Alright. Then other 2 are tertiary. Which are called tertiary? N. If you have only N nitrogen atom in the porphyrin ring, that is called what? Tertiary atom. Tertiary nitrogen atom. Okay. If you have NH, it is called secondary nitrogen atom. Alright. Now 4 pyrrol ring present are linked together through methane bridges. There are number of methane bridges are present, okay, in the ring. So they are called that like CH double bond CH2 or CH3. Okay. Now you can see here in the structure. So which are the pyrrol ring? This 1, 2, 3, 4 pyrrol rings are present at the 4 corners. These are the corners. Okay. And 4 nitrogens are present. You can see here. But the coordinate bond is not shown here. Okay. So there is a coordinate bond in between the 2 nitrogen atoms form 2 coordinate bonds with the iron. Okay. And one is covalent bond. Okay. Now these are methane bridges. Here double bond CH2. You can see here double bond CH2. This should be CH2. Okay. Carbon 2 for 2 hydrogens, 2 for neighboring. This neighboring carbon. So valency carbon is 4. Okay. CH double bond. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. It should be CH double bond CH2. 2 is missing here. Okay. Then CH3, CH3. Then CH2, CH2, COH. And here you have CH2, CH2, COH. Okay. Then structure of hemoglobin and myoglobin. Iron porphyrin complexes. So structure of hemoglobin and myoglobin. So iron porphyrin complexes. So hemoglobin and myoglobin are nothing but iron porphyrin complex. That means iron is present at the center of the porphyrin ring. Hemoglobin, this is the short form of hemoglobin. Okay, myoglobin MB, hemoglobin HB. Hemoglobin picks up oxygen in the lungs and delivers to different parts of the body. This you know that. So hemoglobin, which is present, it will pick up what oxygen in the lungs and then delivers to the different parts of the body. Then myoglobin, this is the short form of myoglobin. Myoglobin takes up oxygen from the hemoglobin in the muscles and stores it until needed for energetic process. So until it required for energetic process, it will be stored. Where it is stored? In muscles or muscles. Okay. Then deoxygenated hemoglobin transports carbon dioxide as bicarbonate back to the lungs. So carbon dioxide will be brought back to the lungs in the form of a bicarbonate. Okay, and it will become what? It is nothing but now deoxygenated. Once hemoglobin will combine with carbon dioxide, it is called deoxygenated hemoglobin. Okay, once it combines with oxygen, it is called oxyhemoglobin. All right. So deoxygenated hemoglobin transports carbon dioxide as bicarbonate, and it will come back to what? Lungs. Okay, using some of its amino groups. Next slide. Now what is the structure of myoglobin? Myoglobin contains heme group with polypeptide chain. Polypeptide chain is represented in short as PPC, okay, of globin, which contains 150 to 160 amino acid residues. Okay, amino acid residues are represented in short as AAR, folded about single heme group. Now porphyry ring has four pyrrole groups linked by methane bridges. Okay, you know that porphyry ring contains four pyrrole groups. Okay, where are the four pyrrole groups present? At the four corners. All right, so they are linked by, how they are linked? Through methane bridges. Iron is present at the center of the heme, is bonded to four nitrogen atoms from four pyrroles of porphyrin and one nitrogen atom from imidazole side chain of histidine, which is a part of long chain protein chain, that is AAR. What is AAR? Amino acid residue. Okay, next slide. Now PPC, this is important. This is not PCC, PPC. Okay, polypeptide chain is important role, plays important role in biological fixation of oxygen. Now sixth coordination site is bonded to oxygen. You can see here sixth coordinate site, this is sixth coordinate site bonded to oxygen. One is a long chain histidine residue, you can see here down. Okay, this is another, okay, residue here, another residue here. Next slide. Myoglobin containing heme group and polypeptide chain. This is the schematic representation or short diagram, okay, short way of representing myoglobin. Okay, you can see here the porphyry rings. Where are the porphyry rings? A, B, C, D. There are four porphyry rings. Okay, and you can see the methane bridges. CH double bond CH3 here. Okay, this is CH double bond CH3. So four coordinated sites are present to this ion. Ion, what oxidation state is exists? Ion 2. Okay, the nitrogen atom, you can see here nitrogen atom, here you can see coordinate bond. Okay, this is the coordinate bond but not shown here. This is the covalent bond, and ion is bonded to oxygen atom. Okay, this is oxygen atom here, that is oxygen molecule. This is long histidine chain, okay, or polypeptide chain in general. Next slide. Structure of hemoglobin, that is HB. Now what is the structure of hemoglobin? It is tetramer of myoglobin with the molecular mass is about 64,500. Okay, so this is the large molecular mass of one hemoglobin. Four heme groups bonded to PPC and one heme group with the protein chain is called subunit. Okay, so four heme groups are present in one, they present and one protein chain. The four subunits are similar but not identical. So altogether there are four subunits are present. They are similar but they are not identical. Now two beta subunits are present. Okay, 146 amino acid residues, somewhat similar to myoglobin. And then out of four subunits, two are beta subunits, okay, and two are alpha subunits. So two altogether, two alpha and two beta. Okay, now what are these two alpha subunits contain? They contain 141 amino acid residues. Two beta subunits contain 146 amino acid residues, as and two alpha subunits contain 141 amino acid residues. Okay, so this is less similar to myoglobin. Now this hemoglobin has five coordinated ion in the second oxidation state, bonded to four nitrogen atoms with the fifth protein and sixth to weakly bonded water. Okay, next slide. Hemoglobin has an octahedral ion 2 complex. Fe2 is in a central place and four corners of the square base occupies nitrogen atom of pyrrole ring of porphyrin. Iron 2 is in high spin state. Now, how does iron exist? It exists in high spin state, that is 3d6. How does the 3d6 orbitals are present? In T2g, 4 electrons are present, Eg, 2 electrons are present. Okay. And 4 unpaired electrons present in Hb molecule. You can see here 4 unpaired electrons are present. So, 2 here and then 2 over here, unpaired electrons are present. Sixth position is occupied by molecular oxygen hemoglobin and myoglobin to give oxyhemoglobin and then oxymyoglobin. Okay. Sixth position usually it will be occupied by water, but if it is oxyhemoglobin, oxymyoglobin, then water will be replaced by oxygen. Okay. So, oxygen in hemoglobin and in myoglobin, oxymyoglobin. Then iron salt will be oxidized easily, but iron in deoxyhemoglobin and deoxymyoglobin is not oxidized. So, in oxidized form, it will be present in oxyhemoglobin, whereas in deoxidized form, in deoxyhemoglobin or myoglobin. Okay. Because of protein chain surrounding ion, which blocks oxidation as well as solvation also prevented. Next, the structure of hemoglobin, you can see one more simple structure of hemoglobin. You can see alpha chain here, beta chain here, they are given in different colors. Okay, this is heme, here iron 2, somewhere at the center. Alright, next slide. Schematic representation of hemoglobin. This is a simple way of representing hemoglobin. Okay, now how do you represent hemoglobin? Hemoglobin consists of 4 heme groups, correct? These are the 3 heme groups, heme 1, heme 2, heme 3. And this part, entire this part up to here is 1 heme. Okay, that means 4th heme. So, this entire part is 4th one heme. So, total altogether 4 hemes will be present in hemoglobin. Okay. So, iron you can see here Fe2 plus bonded to 4 nitrogen atoms of pyro ring. These pyro rings are not shown here. Okay, this is just schematic representation. Therefore, all the pyro rings are not shown here. Okay, only nitrogen atoms are shown. So, iron 2 plus bonded to 4 nitrogen atoms you can see here. Okay, and then this is OH2. OH2 is nothing but water. On one side it is bonded to water. Okay, another side it is weakly bonded to histidine residue, that is long polypeptide chain. Okay. Polypeptide chain, this is the globin molecule. Okay, so this is the schematic representation of hemoglobin. Now, role of hemoglobin and myoglobin. Now, what is the role of hemoglobin and myoglobin? In transportation of oxygen from the lungs to tissue and carbon dioxide from the tissues to lungs. Now, what does it do? It will transport oxygen from the lungs to the tissues and carbon dioxide from the tissues to the lungs. Okay. Now, partial pressure of air, that is PP, represented short form as PP, partial pressure of air will be high when we breathe. You know that we are breathing in and breathing out. Okay. Now, when we breathe, partial pressure of air will be high. At this condition, hemoglobin takes up oxygen because we are breathing in air. Air contains oxygen. Therefore, hemoglobin will take up what? Oxygen. Okay. And becomes oxyhemoglobin. So, water bond that will break. Okay. You have seen in the previous line. In between iron and oxygen, there will be weak bond, water H2, that will break and it will become oxygen will come and attach there. Okay, therefore, you get one oxyhemoglobin and is termed as oxygenation. Okay, that is called oxygenation. So, simple way of representing equation is like this. Hemoglobin combines with oxygen forms oxyhemoglobin, that is HbO2 plus hydrogen. Then water molecule in hemoglobin is reversibly replaced by one oxygen. Okay, that I have told you already. Next slide. As the partial pressure of oxygen decreases in tissue, now when blood reaches tissues, the partial pressure of oxygen goes on what? Decreasing. Okay, in tissues, it decreases in tissues and is set free and picked up by myoglobin and stored till needed. So, this oxygen is picked up by myoglobin, which is present in tissues and muscles. Okay. And then stored until it is required. Okay, until then it will be stored there. When oxygen is needed, it is released directly by oxyhemoglobin or myoglobin, oxymyoglobin. Okay, whenever oxygen is needed, it will be released directly either from oxyhemoglobin or oxymyoglobin. Okay, free oxygen release diffuses into body cell. So oxygen release diffuses get diffused into the body cell. Okay, where it will combine with the glucose, which then oxidized to carbon. So, glucose gets oxidized, our cells, glucose will be present, that will oxidize, gets oxidized in the presence of oxygen. Okay, or in other words, oxygen will combine glucose, oxidizes it and gets oxidized to carbon dioxide. water and energy. Okay, you can see in this equation, adenosine triphosphate contains what? Glucose, C6H12O6 combines with oxygen, gets converted into carbon dioxide, water and energy, releasing large amount of energy. Okay. Now, energy is utilized to perform various metabolic processes and to maintain body temperature. So, this energy is used up to perform various reactions, okay, in our body or metabolic process and to maintain one temperature. Okay. Carbon dioxide combines with amino group of hemoglobin to form carboamino hemoglobin. So, carbon dioxide combines with amino group of hemoglobin to form carboamino hemoglobin. When the blood reaches the lungs, carbon dioxide is set free and exhaled down. So, from the tissues or muscles, it will take carbon dioxide and then it will reaches the lungs, okay, and then we exhale out one carbon dioxide. When we inhale, that means breathing in, we take oxygen. When we exhale, okay, carbon dioxide will be released. In oxidation process, H plus is released and it reacts with the bicarbonate dissolved in blood to liberate carbon dioxide. Okay, so bicarbonate ion will be present, that will be combined with the H plus. Okay, oxidation process, H plus is released, that will combine to form carbonic acid H2CO3, and then this will dissolve into water and carbon dioxide. Okay, so this is the mathematical way of representation of exhale and inhale. You can see here, inhale pressure will be 100 torr. Torr is the unit of representing pressure. You can see the reaction, carbon dioxide gets turned into bicarbonate in the presence of H plus. Okay, so you can see here respiration process, myoglobin, what is the pressure here in the myoglobin? Oxygen pressure 20 to 30, that means less pressure because myoglobin is present in muscles and on tissues of the cells. Okay, whereas this is present in, oxygen is present in the lungs, 100 torr. Okay, high pressure here, low pressure. All right, so gas exchange in humans. So this is the representation: oxygen, carbon dioxide, lungs, organs. Okay, transport of carbon dioxide in the blood, that is shown here from plasma cell, red blood cells. Okay, so I will stop at this stage. All right, so please go through all these slides. Any difficulty, you please contact me. Okay, thank you.